This is difficult topic for numerical mathematician, difficult to understand, because it demands understanding from mathematical logic. I'll try to tell anything that you need to know. Nevertheless, difficult to understand. Step by step. Okay. You should read. Carefully. I will comment that the explanation is necessary. You see, I wrote the first version of this paper when I begin to think about what can be done for the future with the use of current parallel computing technologies. You see, the model of parallel computing has a model of high abstraction that can be applied for different applications. I did it, and as a result, this paper was written, being modified every year, and after 5 years, I have this result, and would like to present it to you in such a way. First, historical considerations. You see, the volume of technologies was not very big. And if some new technology was developed, that previously known, well-known technology should be forgotten. Because nowhere to keep the knowledge about technologies. You see, as a result, during 40 years, there were no progress in the technology's development. At last 5,000 years, progress was gone very quickly. Because the writing was developed and literacy was widely spread, means that the new technology could be described and after that studied. And as a result, many technologies could be in use. More technologies could be in use. This is the role of literacy in the development of human society. No literacy, no human society. Impossible to provide the life more than start 100 person in one community. Now we have also a similar situation that we had 45,000 years ago. We have now the passive way of technology description. And also, if a technology is not in active use, such technology can be forgotten. I read, maybe 30 years ago, that in USSR, about 40,000 early discovered deposits were lost. How we can to overcome this limitation with the use of computers and current computing technologies? The way is Active and passive of not knowledge, knowledge representation. That's my point. Knowledge is knowledge. But representation are different. A technology, any technology. First, way to use technology. For example, to fly on the aircraft. You see, everybody can't fly. In order to exploit technology of flying, there should be special people, experts, pilot, many people should prepare aircraft on the surface. You see? Many people should control the flight. You see, this is a very complex technology, and everybody can't fly without assistance of many, many, many people. You see? Intelligent algorithms. This algorithm can substantially simplify the technology exploitation, and everybody can do, can exploit the technology. We have such example. For example, the cars. As you know, car was bought 50 years ago with the driver, because everybody could not drive car. 50 years. No, maybe 80. 80 years ago. But now, the algorithm of driving and car maintaining have so high quality that everybody can drive anywhere. Nothing to know about how the car was constructed, designed. Nobody knows. For example, I don't know. I hope you also don't know. In such a way, for technology exploitation, the group of experts should be involved in exploitation. In the latter case, numerous applications of technology can be done by the user simply enough without the assistance. Second way is far more attractive. Now, in computing technologies, there were developed several approaches to program synthesis. Program synthesis means program automatic constructions for solution of a specified problem. If you can implement at least one of such technologies, then the problem of active knowledge will be solved. The problem is, the knowledge should be understood, description of the knowledge should be understood by computer. If computer can understand the technology described in some text or some other representation, then computer can apply this technology without human being. That would be absolutely not educating yourself, if you want something. Why we say passive form? Because if we have the description of some technology, many books, for example, describing a technology, how to fly, but we can't fly. Because computer, for example, doesn't understand the text, can't extract the knowledge from the book, from the text, and as a consequence, such a computer can't apply the technology. But what should do? This is example. If you have the book describing bridge construction, you can't put the book on the table to say magic wand and to magic wand. Do you know magic wand? And bridge will not be constructed because knowledge in the book is in passive form. But you need to develop such representation of the knowledge, how to construct the bridge. You see, if we say the magic wand, to say some magic construction, then the bridge should be immediately be constructed. This is active knowledge. Active knowledge representation. In such a way. In order we could implement it, we should find such knowledge representation that could be understood by a computer, knowledge could be extracted from the description and apply in order to solve a user-specified problem. You see? Such magic wand. I hope you are reading. What the idea is shown here. You see that in order to adopt one technology only, bridge construction, for example, human beings should spend 25 or maybe 40 and even 40 years. After that only, the person is good expert in the area of bridge construction. And you see, so many years were spent for studying and adaptation only one technology. In any other application area, this person will know nothing, practically nothing. It would be better if we can study something, maybe 25, maybe 30, and even 40 years, but after that, we know anything in our computer. We don't need to study anything more in order to be able to use and to exploit any technology. Do you understand? We have now such situation. We are learning every day. We are already 50 or 60 or 70 years old people, but we are learning. If we stop, then we should go out of the flow, mainstream of our life. You see? Maybe this is very well, maybe not. We will see later. Last affirmation is difficult to prove for you. Difficult. But this is so. As you know, many package of programs are really black box. You can't improve, for example, or to extend, excluding some specific cases. And in any case, if there is some module, we can change this module. But we need to do it, because some package are in exploitation already, for example, 20 or 30 years. They must be reconstructed, but we can't. Such a way. How we can construct active knowledge representation? First, mathematical logic says that it's necessary to develop complete enough axiomatic theory. What I meant saying complete enough. Complete enough. Do you know that there is Gödel theories about not completeness of axiomatic series? Axiomatic series. It means that if the theory is complete theory, it means that such theory contains contradiction. If no contradiction, then the theory is incomplete. Thus, if we would like to develop active knowledge representation for some technology, we need to develop axiomatic theory that should be complete enough in order to contain all the problems that I, as user, are going to solve in the frame of this axiomatic theory. This, for example, now we can do it. Cannot do it. Then, application problem is formulated in terms of the axiomatic theory. The desirable algorithm of application problem solution is derived, and automatic problem generation solve the problem in such a way, in order to construct active knowledge representation, we need to develop complete enough axiomatic theory. And after that, the known algorithm provides the possibility to implement the computer system for knowledge extraction from this axiomatic theory. And the problem is, how high the complexity of this problem solution? Problem active knowledge representation. Logic programming. Axiomatic series. therapy, a variable operation. Axioms. If we formulated, if we have formulated some affirmation that can be or not by theorem, if we can prove, then this is theorem. If we can't prove, this is not theorem. In such a way, how high complex of such proof? We need to construct the derivations of all the information. How many such information? Huge number. Practically always the number of such different ways 10^20. There are 10^50. Do you know how big this number? For example, number of atoms in our world, visible world, only 10^43. Atoms, not molecular atoms. You see? And I saw the reference, the axiomatic theory, where one of theorem can be proved, but with the 10^100 different variants. In such a way, to prove such theorem, the proof can be found only incidentally. You see, in such a way, this is not technology. In such a way, it's necessary to simplify axiomatic theory representation and proof of theorems. If we can do it, then the problem of active knowledge, technology, implementation can be solved. Nice. No, maybe this is not interesting, but please read if we are here. Our approach is implemented. There is a computer system that can do it. Can implement our approach. First, it's necessary to formulate the requirements to axiomatic theory representation. Technological requirements. I would like to draw this term, technological algorithm, technological solution, technological requirement. Technological is used, this term is used in order to characterize the notion or requirement or something that can be implemented for linear time or so. You see? It's clear. You see? Because this is exponential time for solution. What ideas? First idea. To develop such axiomatic theory where only one, the only necessary problem can be solved. The problem may be 2, 3, 5, 10 maybe, but few problems can be solved in the frame of this axiomatic theory. In classical mathematical logic, we can do it, because if necessary to extend the problem that can be solved in the frame of axiomatic theory, it's necessary to add new axioms. But if we add new axiom, we don't know how wide theory, how many problems will contain such axiomatic theory. You see, in such a way, very quickly, the such axiomatic theory can be not implementable in this sense, to have very high complexity. In such a way, we need to find such representation of axiomatic theory where only necessary, maybe one only problem is solved. And there is only one way. In such a way, any step of derivation lead to the goal. Derived algorithm should be represented as a set of functional terms, recursively countable set of the functional terms. This follows from the theory of algorithms. If you look at the linear characterization of computable function, you'll find this result. Why we need to represent an algorithm as a recursively countable set of functional terms? Because computer can understand such a description of the algorithm. And computer will be able, if there is such an algorithm, computer will be able automatically to generate a program implementing this algorithm. See, this is kernel idea on this step. And final line says that ability to operate with axiomatic theory will define soon the literacy of human being. Also from here. Why we need to be able easy to extend the axiomatic theory? We need to do it technologically, in technology. If we know this, if we can't satisfy this demand, then there will not be technology. We need to do it why? Because we create the axiomatic theory solution, the only problem. But if we need to solve another problem, what we should do? We need to extend the description of axiomatic theory and to add very few in this theory. Very few, but enough in order to solve one new additional technology. You see, exactly this only, nothing more. Like this is done in logic, in the theory of predicates of first order. Because, as I said, if we add new axiom, we don't know how wide will be a new axiomatic theory. Program generated automatically should possess by all the desirable properties. major properties. I listed here far less than half of such properties. Many properties should be provided in the course of program generation. So I hope you know all the terms. Understandable. Okay. Step by step, we reach the point where we can define the notion, technological notion of knowledge. Please read. Such a technological method to describe knowledge. And human being working with such axiomatic theory should not think, should not know anything about knowledge, about entity of knowledge. You see, should not know any algorithm. Human being should only to formulate the problem. That's all, nothing more also. It's necessary to have here. We have now the example such knowledge representation, the most widely used and well-known well-known representation of the knowledge is calculator. You see, all our knowledge of arithmetic is included into the calculator. Nobody now can know the details of arithmetic, but the user should be able to formulate a problem. For example, press button and explain to calculator it's necessary to take the value 3, to add the 5, and to give the result. You see? This is very simple example, but it demonstrates what we should do with the big volume of our knowledge that are learned now in the libraries without any useful activity, you see? Okay. We should simplify the knowledge description. It means the description of axiomatic theories. I'll give you next slide, I'll demonstrate you not serious example that commands this idea. Okay? Did you read? Okay? This is not serious example. Imagine yourself. There is an impossible jungle. Do you know jungle? Yeah. Impossible jungle. How human beings should study this jungle? Nobody is not studying jungle as a whole. Usually there are such brave people that will cross the jungle from point X0 to X3. Through the jungle and provide the pass. You see? These first people don't study the whole jungle. They don't know about jungles, but they know the way. some of these brave people will be eaten by the tiger, for example, or maybe something else. But nevertheless, after these people, brave people, the other people that know John Fowler, then it's necessary in order to cross to make new paths, but they will be able to go from point X zero to point X three. Okay? In the same way, in other passes can be developed. You see this one, this one. And you see we have here now the ways that were not especially developed. For example, this way, this Z0, X1, Z1, X2, X3. Especially this path was not developed, but it is. And now we can solve optimization problem. For example, if we need to go from X0 to X3, we could take this path. But if tiger, hungry tiger, away you, then it's better to take another way, to go to X, to X1, after that to Z1, after that to X2, and after that X3. This is the best way in this case. You see? And each path actually is the image of the algorithm. Operation A1 do anything in order the person could go from X0 to X1 and go on. Actually, any path is the algorithm. Okay? Oh, excuse me, please, no commands, not enough commands. This is the idea of structural program synthesis contrary to logic programming. Because in structural program synthesis, we operate with passes. Nothing know about whole jungle. You see? The same we need to do in axiomatic theories. You see? Providing, developing the partial description of axiomatic area, partial. And working with partial axiomatic theories where we can prove or disprove only finite number of affirmations. Okay? It's the same what we do with the passes. Last necessary idea is to represent an axiomatic theory not with the use of a set of axioms, but keeping only the steps of derivation. The steps of derivation. You see, each module, for example, each module represents one step of algorithm derivation in some axiomatic theory. I'll demonstrate. this is module with its input and output variables. I said that this model describes one step of algorithm derivation in some axiomatic theory in which this module is included. How we can show it? Not proof, show. It's okay. This is affirmation A. Okay? This is B. A means that all the variables have right values. Not correct, as we say about module in the library, but right module. What does it mean? That these values of this variable define some object of axiomatic theory. For example, triangle. X, Y, Z denote this variable, denote the line of the triangle. You see, and we say that the values of this variable is right if the value describes such a line that can be constructed in triangles. If the values doesn't permit to construct triangle, these values are not right. I said these values should be right and describe some object of axiomatic theory in the real world. Okay? Then what does it mean, this affirmation? It means that module is developed correctly. And if correct values are here, then definitely output will be computed correctly. In such a way, one application of the module define one step of algorithm derivation. In such a way, any computational model for which each operation strongly defined to which variables it can be applied, not such as in library of modules, where module can be applied to any set of variables, but exactly to that variable that defined for this module. In computational model, in such a way, when we say take one module to connect another model, third model, and go on, actually we derive the proof of some information. Did you understand?
Yeah.
Nice? I like it. Also would like to comment. You see, we have now the computational model that provide the derivation of algorithm to compute y variable from x variable. But if we need to compute some extra variable, we can add operation very simply to extend our theory. We do it many times. Any programming, good programming with long time experience, understand it very well. No, the programmer and the people working in technologies don't think long time about about technological definition. For example, we need to describe, to define what is the unit of knowledge. Okay, this is module. What we can suggest more? Nothing. This is clear, nothing special. So certainly the set of model is not the knowledge base. Because there are different relations, especially always there exist information dependencies relations that should be defined for the set of module in any knowledge base. Okay, what is said here? That such knowledge, active knowledge representation as a set of model and information dependencies relation means that we always define partial axiomatic theory. Partial. Such description of the axiomatic theory where we are able to solve only one to a finite number of necessary for us problems. The best situation for us. Last affirmation means that we can work with algorithm and programs. We don't need to consider some technological facilities, aircraft, military, ships and go on. We can work only with algorithms and programs. Okay, axiomatic theory that described geometry. Certainly follow to our principles, our ideas. We are not going to describe the whole axiomatic theory to solve any geometric problem. We have a problem, triangle. It's known that variable x, z, alpha, gamma, and alpha are known, the values are known, you see? And it's necessary to compute the value of variable s, square of triangle. Certainly, we don't need to develop the whole axiomatic theory. We use this notion and describe the axiomatic theory where all these terms are defined. You see? There are two, three angles. Two, three. We can calculate third angle. insert. After that, module D1, if the, we know the value of angle B better, we can use the value of Z and to compute the height HX. After that, the module F1 provides the calculation of the variable S. In such a way, we derive the algorithm to calculate the value of variable S. Our axiomatic theory is very simple. Complexity of derivation is, I don't know, more simple way of knowledge representation. I think this is the most simple. Okay, from the viewpoint of user, he has the description of the notion cycle, the notion triangle, partial description. After that, notion of cycle is combined with the notion of triangles. There is a common variable, and we can derive the algorithm of how to compute A from R. You see? The, what is the idea here? We have description of the problem, formulation of the problem, and on the basis of problem formulation, we can construct actually partial axiomatic theory. You see, technologically, this is very, very suitable. Very suitable. Because the person should not think about axiomatic theories. Axiomatic theory is extracted from the initial data, initial formulation of the problem. In such a way, what is said here? That ability to operate with axiomatic theory, ability to describe axiomatic theory, will be the basis of future education, and literacy, future literacy, should be based on the ability to describe axiomatic theory. Ну, not only to describe, but also to operate, to extend the axiomatic theory, or to reduce and so on. Second idea is that in computational models, initially we say that nothing new can be derived. Can be derived in our description of axiomatic theories. You see that we substantially simplified the work with axiomatic theories. We should pay now for this. It can't be done free of charge. If we simplify the work with axiomatic theory, that we should pay. We pay deleting from axiomatic theory the possibility to derive something new, new algorithm, for example, that nobody knows. But the idea of a computational model is different. The idea is, if somebody, somewhere, can do something better than anybody else over the world, then this knowledge should be included into the computational models, and after that, everybody should be able to work with the quality of the best expert. I think this is very good result. I would be glad to use such a system. Not thinking about anything. Actually, approach now implemented in Lunar project. Luna project is called fragmented programming system Luna. And Luna is positioned as a system of programming. But actually it's implemented as a system, for implementation of axiomatic theory described, as I said here. Described on the basis of theory of structural program synthesis. And by the way, automatic generation of a program implementing derived algorithm is a very complex method, very complex project. As system of programming, not operation with axiomatic theories, with knowledge, but only as programming system, this Luna is under development already 10 years. And we are not satisfied. New literacy. Let's read. Phonetic literacy is okay, but phonetic literacy provides only passive knowledge representation that can't be applied directly to solving specified problems. Now we try to construct the system for direct application of knowledge in active form. And certainly we should, the people working with axiomatic theory should use proper literacy, for description of axiomatic theories. You can consider in what class you fall now. With phonetic literacy, you fall in the class of literate people. Okay? Look at the new literacy. Please try to recognize into class you can fall concerning new literacy. No, for you this is not so important, but for your children or grandchildren, you should worry about good education for them, because if they know maybe not mathematics, but axiomatic theory, the theory of predicate of the first order, they will fall into the class of illiterate people. It means they will not find the job. No, I meant a good job where you can do anything with your mind. Did you understand? This is serious thing. Now we can be laughing at it. But tomorrow it will not be laughing. We will cry. Very much. Okay. please read this paper. What is said here? It's said here that earlier, phonetically, the human being is able to adopt only one application area. You see? But with new literacy, it's possible to adopt, for example, 10 or maybe 50 application areas. Because human being will need only to be able to formulate the problem, to know the main terms in order to formulate the problem, nothing more. And this will be the basis of education in 20 or maybe 50 years. Give to your children and grandchildren such education that they could fall into the last class, the class of people developing the active knowledge basis. This will be the most expensive work. Definitely. Conclusion. Last phrase means that we certainly will be doing by the development of programming system, but less and less, because more necessary will be the system implementing axiomatic theories, like Luna. And finally, new literacy is extremely dangerous thing. Extremely dangerous. You see, with the use of active knowledge, the people will not need to think at all. It means our population in 100 years will be transformed into the world. In such a way, we expect that the population will be more resilient. You see, nothing could put. Okay, that's all what I would like to tell you. Hope it will be more or less interesting. Okay, your questions, please. Oh, no, no, no. I forgot to demonstrate. You see, this paper was published this year. This year, I have no yet printed volume in the lecture notes of computer science. In such a way, this is absolutely fresh material. this volume is not under distribution now. Nobody received it yet. Hope you are surprised.
Any question from the participant?
Regarding the LoRa project, the multinationality project, or is it only the
project of Russian Academy of Science?
Yes, Russian Academy of Science.
I invite my colleagues, Malaysian colleagues to participate if you want.
Because before I came to the chat, I tried to search for Luna online, but I didn't find any result. Is there any...
Well, there are many publications about Luna. Many publications.
A lot. Yes.
If you need the references, I'll prepare for you. Okay? Maybe not all of them, but I'll prepare.
Tutorial?
Not no, there is tutorial here, but there are publications in international journals, and I can give you the list. You can find it. Okay, if you remind me, tomorrow or after tomorrow, we will. List of publication about Luna.
So actually Luna, just a brief Luna, it is what you are doing with positive ion is UDA, right?
Yes,
UDA. UDA is GPU CPU.
Yes.
So you are focuses on the shared memory architecture, and this is, you can't see the distributed or partition of the data. But this is the Luna. Luna is a distributed parallel system, and the architecture is different, where the communication is based on the fragmented programming, and then the computational is based on the C of the traffic. So that is integrated with the message passing interface as an engine, but the interface is based on the fragmented. That is possible very easily, especially if we have a distributed computing architecture. A shared memory architecture like GPU, CPU that we are using in the course of the Mario is much, much expensive.
Yes.
So they're using
to buy
NVIDIA, you know, processor expensive. We also have one, and we're going to buy another one. But the one is, this one is a distributed, you can use CPU.
Open source.
You can use the open source system, use that CPU, you know, the CPU distributed CPU. So no cost, you can check. And before this, we are using many software, but Luna is considered.
What about the program language?
Luna. The program language is Luna.
Luna itself.
So, any question?
Yes. So this is a new technology, new what it is?
No, but the language of Luna input language is the set description of the set of modules, yes, as units of knowledge, and set of variables to which the modules can be applied, we can explain. That's all, nothing more. Certainly, when we start to describe a numerical algorithm, it's necessary to add some construction that facilitate the description of numerical algorithm. But they are not substantial. It's possible without such facilities to use Luna.
Actually,
you can
read the need for something in data than the
No, we plan maybe next year up to the summer to install here the version of Luna in the lab of Norma. And we plan to teach the students of the Norma and they will be able to work here. And certainly remote access also can be provided. It depends on Norma. I don't know many details of implementation. This is too much for me.
So, okay, the implementation on the GPU, right? Distributed?
No, please. I would like to formulate this exactly. You see that because we say about axiomatic series, then algorithm of problem formulated problem solution is derived automatically. After that, if you have derived algorithm, you can generate program for any for different equipment, for the multi computers with one or another topology of communication communication things. You see, in such a way, input data for Luna system is description of the axiomatic theory. Input and output variables of the problem and description of the hardware. And Luna look at this and generate the proper program.
So both is applicable for GPU and CPU.
Sorry?
I mean applicable, it can be implemented for GPU and CPU.
It's possible if this model will be done. For now it's not done. Because it's necessary to spend many efforts in order to develop. But you can do it. For example, you can invite 1, 2, 3 students. We will teach such a person and we will develop it. We can explain how to do it. For now, for us, this is not very important problem. Have another more important for us problem. But we are ready to go. You see that basic, this logic programming. But logic programming is not technological, it is not implemented. And we try to reduce this approach, like we is demonstrated by the passage. Nothing more. I didn't tell you nothing new theoretically. This is well known, maybe at least 30 years, maybe 40. But the problem is how to implement it. Before it was not possible to do. Now we can do it. And this is the novelty of our approach. reduction of axiomatic theory representation. Such reduction, the derivation, can be done for technologically acceptable time. Contrary to example with 10 to power 100 complexity of the numeric derivation. Yeah, we have no such complexities.
So no other solutions.
Yes, for example, if you know numerical algorithm, numerical methods, the most developed problem is the implementation of particle cell method in its application to astrophysics, and solution Monte Carlo problems, whatever, this one. But particle cell method now can implement very few things, especially fully implemented. Maybe 1, 2, 3, maybe 3, maybe 4, maybe 5, very few overdo because of complexity of its implementation. But these algorithms are already included in the loop. And if you describe the application of Luna for solution of some problem, program will be generated.
What are the addition of these applications? Do you compare to others? Do you have to do anything else?
No, no, we can do anything. But you see, now we have the possibility to derive an algorithm. After that, we need to extend our Luna system in order to be able to generate one program, another, third, countable number of different sub-areas where we can use Luna. In such a way, we can do this one, this again, but we will not do because there are no people good educated, able to work with us. And I say, explain you, if you need to generate the program for CUDA, please find several people that will develop it for you. Exactly. Because where I'll find qualified people. I explained, I read to teach these people. I'll explain anything. I'll explain how to work. You see? No another way. This is Academy of Sciences. Our objective to demonstrate to the industry what can be done. We demonstrate.
Thank you. upcoming centuries. So on behalf of the Munich Institute Center for Sustainable Nanomaterials, right, we are going to give the certificate of the speaker for seminar series 4. Thank you very much.
It will be normally if tomorrow you will remember some questions. I invite you to my room here, and I will be ready to answer your question tomorrow before noon. Because at about 3 or 4 p.m. I leave Johor Bahru, Okinawa. Okay, then in 2 days, if tomorrow. Before you will give me your question, then after the
talk. You can meet prof tomorrow, 26 and 26. 25th prof is not here, okay? Prof will go to the event. But tomorrow and 26. So we will do a lot for any question discussion. And if, we will also provide the room, so I just go straight. Tomorrow there is a workshop too for Luna. Tomorrow is a workshop too. And then, I forgot.